What do these pictures have in common? They are all real images taken in space. So, where are all the stars? Whenever we see rocket launches, moon landing pictures, or even videos from the International Space Station, there never seems to be any stars visible in the background. It just looks dark. And this started one of the biggest conspiracy theories in history. So, to answer why and prove that scientists aren't lying to you, we need to look at how cameras work in space, and also what astronauts actually see with their own eyes when they are up there.
It's an unfathomable blackness, like a texture you feel like you could stick your hand into.
The sky is a deep black.
On February 7th, 1984, five astronauts were on board the Challenger space shuttle about to make history. Their task was to perform the first ever untethered spacewalk in history. During every other spacewalk before this, the astronauts would be connected to the spacecraft using a safety line, but not this time. The astronaut Bruce McCandless enters the cargo bay wearing his jetpack, and as he steps out, he declares, "It may have been one small step for Neil, but it's a heck of a big leap for me." Robert Gibson, the flight's pilot, took out the Hasselblad camera on board, set the exposure, and captured this image, one of the most famous images ever taken in space. He was free to float away. But do you notice something strange? Where are all the stars? And it's not the camera's fault. The astronauts themselves reported that while they were up there in orbit, the sky appears to be a deep, textured, inky black color. Topics like this always blew my mind growing up, but nothing came close to the amazement I felt when learning about quantum physics. Quantum mechanics teaches us about the very small of the universe, and it truly feels like magic. And that's why I've once again partnered with MagellanTV. I've been watching this awesome documentary on MagellanTV called Secrets of Quantum Physics, which dives into all of the insane physics of the quantum world. Topics like quantum entanglement will definitely break your brain. In a good way, of course. If you enjoy my videos, which I hope you do, then I'm sure you'll love this documentary as well as the hundreds of other amazing documentary pieces they have ready to stream now. And what makes it even better is MagellanTV is completely ad-free. It's just an affordable way to consume high-quality science and tech content. All you need to do is click the link at the top of the description box to sign up today and watch Secrets of Quantum Physics. Viewers of the channel will get a 7-day free trial as well as some amazing discounts on gift cards for the holiday season. To figure out why stars aren't seen in any of these images or videos taken in space, we need to understand how camera exposure works, and honestly, it's really intuitive. All cameras have something called a shutter speed. This is basically just how long the shutter of the camera stays open, allowing light to hit the sensor and be captured. Of course, the more light captured on the sensor, the brighter the image will appear. You've already experienced this when you are using your phone camera and you can just adjust the brightness really easily like this. Now, in all of these images and videos, the subject is not the stars in the background. The focus is on the things in the foreground, whether it be the astronauts or the Earth or even the spacecraft, and they are all properly exposed. But these objects in the foreground are just much brighter than the stars in the background because they are being bathed in just as much sunlight as we experience during the day down here on Earth. So it's impossible to expose both the astronauts in the foreground as well as the beautiful stars in the background using the same image. One of them has to be either overexposed or underexposed. This is exactly why we can't typically see the stars from images captured in space. It's not some big conspiracy. And the best part is, when you consider these facts beforehand, you can actually plan for it and take some pretty spectacular images and videos of the stars in space. But there is still one question that has not been answered. Why can't the astronauts see the stars with their own eyes when they are in space?
The sky is a deep black.
It's an unfathomable blackness, like a texture you feel like you could stick your hand into.
We were never able to see stars from the lunar surface or on the daylight side of the moon by eye without looking through the optics. I don't recall during the period of time that we were photographing the Sona Corolla what stars we could see. I don't remember seeing any.
And the reason why this happens is because our eyes are really just like tiny little cameras. They adjust the exposure naturally by dilating the pupils. If you're in a bright place, like on a beach in the sun or on the surface of the moon, your pupils shrink down to physically block how much light is being let in. And then if you're in a dark place, like your bedroom at night or in the depths of space, your pupils will grow larger, allowing more light in. And that's why astronauts on the ISS, or those who visited the moon in the Apollo missions, reported that they couldn't see the stars in the sky with their naked eye, because their eyes were just adjusted for the bright reflective surface of the moon. Okay, side note, but when I was researching for this video, I came across so many bloopers of astronauts on the moon falling over, and they were just too funny not to show you.
No, dadgummit. Whoop. Okay. Ah. Hey, do I like to run up here? I feel like Bugs Bunny. That's me.
Now, the only place that the Apollo astronauts were able to see the stars while they were on the moon was actually here in the shadow of the lunar lander. If they stood in this shadow for long enough and let their eyes adjust to the darkness, the universe would slowly start to reveal itself. And this made me wonder, what will astronauts actually see with their own eyes when we start to go back to the moon over the next few years, since they will actually just be landing at the lunar south pole, where it is much darker? I recently visited the European Space Agency's astronaut training facility, where I did a moonwalk simulation, and I actually asked about what the stars will look like from the lunar south pole.
Is the sky true to what it would look like?
Yes. Yeah, so you'd expect more stars, right? But actually, compared to the glariness of the surroundings with the sun,
yeah,
you don't really see the stars.
So when the Artemis astronauts make their journey to the south pole of the moon over the next few years, they will still be treated to that inky black sky. But if they spend enough time in the dark craters, they will undoubtedly be able to see the entirety of the universe, unobstructed by light pollution and an atmosphere. Okay, and one last thing. I've recently been loving these beautiful long exposure astrophotography images from the astronaut Don Pettit. Don is actually on board the ISS right now, and sometime over the next few weeks, I'll actually be live calling into the ISS to chat with Don about life in space as an astronaut. So if you had any questions that you wanted me to ask Don or any of the other astronauts on board the ISS, then I want you to comment them down below. And if your question is good, I will literally just ask the astronauts in space above your head right now. So next time someone tells you that you can't see stars in space and it's this big conspiracy, just send them this video.